Let us see the example of partial derivatives. Let us calculate first order partial derivatives. So we have the function find dabba f by dabba x and dabba f by dabba y for f is equal to log x and sine y. Okay, so we consider the first order partial derivatives. So this is the partial derivative of f with respect to x. This is the partial derivative of f with respect to y. So we need to understand let f is equal to log of x and sine of y. And now we want to find the partial derivative of f with respect to x. So we have to differentiate this f partially with respect to x. So differentiating f partially with respect to x, we get. So what we'll get is dabba f by dabba x is equal to dabba by dabba x of log x into sine y. Now we need to understand one thing. When we are differentiating with respect to x and partially, then y is treated as a constant, or the function of y will be also constant. So here this term will be treated as a constant, and hence we can have this is equal to sine of y into dabba by dabba x of log x. So remember also one thing, that all the formulas, whatever we have seen in the total derivative, will be as it is they are. And so we want to find out the derivative of this log x. So we know the derivative of log x is 1 by x, and hence the derivative will be sine of y into 1 by x. So we got the first order partial derivative of f with respect to x is sine of y upon x. So this is what we'll be having, the first derivative. Now we want dabba f by dabba y. So we have to differentiate this f with respect to y partially. Now we'll differentiate this f. So differentiating y. So here we are differentiating f with respect to y partially, we get. So what we have to do is dabba f by dabba y is equal to dabba by dabba y of log of y, log of x into sine of y. So that's what we have. And now when we are differentiating with respect to y, the other variable x is treated as a constant. So we have this log x remains as it is, and dabba by dabba y of sine y. We know the derivative of sine is going to be cosine. So we get here, this is log of y, log of x into cos of y. So we get the derivative of f with respect to y partially. We have this is a log x into cos of y. So this way we are able to find the first order partial derivatives of the function f.